Let's dive into the anatomy of a shot and really understand why breaking up the shot into categories is so important. But before we jump in, let's just understand something. A lot of times what people do is they actually accuse us of actually reinventing basketball because obviously we're creating terminology. But here's what I want you to understand. When it comes to shooting, there isn't a whole lot of terminology to begin with. So it's not that we're reinventing anything, we're actually creating terminology in order to break up shooting into smaller categories so we can better teach it. For instance, with shooting, typically all I was ever taught was that there was some kind of shooting pocket, which is somewhere in here. And then obviously there was a set point where it almost gave me the picture of setting the ball into place. And then of course I would simply have a follow through. So that's all I really had to go on when I was learning how to shoot as a player. So what we've done with our actual terminology and breaking up the anatomy of a shot is we're actually creating terms and breaking this up into pieces that gives us a better opportunity to really understand the nuances and the variety of what actually happens when shooting the basketball.
Now understand, shooting can be such a detailed part of the game when we're teaching it, but it's really important that those details are well defined so we can have a better understanding of not only how to teach ourselves how to shoot, but to teach players how to shoot. So our first stage of shooting that we're going to talk about here would be our pickup point or our catch point. Those two can kind of interchange depending on what part of the game I'm playing. Now the difference with those two is would be obviously ultimately the situation. I could be catching from across my body, I could be catching more ball coming to me, I could be able also catching a bad pass that's either low or high. That can kind of change it. But ultimately where I'm gonna bring the ball to is gonna be very similar. Now same thing, my pickup point would obviously be more talking about coming off the dribble. Now depending on what type of a dribble I'm talking about, if I'm coming out of a crossover, that ball might be floating, my pickup point can still ultimately change here. Now the typical pickup point would be more center of my body. So if I was really open and I didn't have to worry about any defenders, that pickup point would more so likely center up. Now if I had a defender's hand on my left hip or right hip, now my pickup point might change a little bit. I might have to come get it at my right hip, right knee, left knee, or even up at my shoulder depending upon if I'm floating the ball. So pickup points can ultimately change.
So all we've done with our terminology is we've created more understanding of the separate pieces of a shot. So obviously from our start point, the ball actually has to move up some kind of path, which we of course call the lift path. Now once again, this terminology and this understanding of this detail of the shot has never been termed up or named. And so a lot of times it's never been talked about. That's what we always talk about when we talk about terminology. If you don't have a name for it, you're probably not teaching it. And so the concept of a lift path is extremely important because that's the actual path the ball has to travel to actually get to your shot. See, the old way of shooting was always pull the ball to the same start point and always move through the same lift path. But really, when you look at shooting in the game of basketball, players have mastered the ability to shoot from different lift paths. So if I'm from the left hip, the path the ball takes to actually get to my lift path or my lift point is gonna be different than if I started the ball here. Now it's a completely different path to get to the same shot. And so being able to teach players how to access different lift paths is extremely important. So when we label that category, we can start to really train players for the ability to shoot from more than one lift path. Now the lift point is the area that you could argue that we've made a change to, because obviously set point did exist. But like I said in the beginning, if you say set point, you've created a picture of actually setting the ball down, which creates more of that hitch type of quality that a lot of people complain about. And so you start getting in this argument of whether or not you're a one motion or two motion shooter, all because you've created a picture that says set point. So if I'm gonna set the ball anywhere, I've obviously created that separate motion. But a lift point is simply the part, the place that the ball travels to before it's finally pushed through into your release. And that lift point can of course change.
Now our lift point now can be multiple different spots. This is where not every shot is gonna be the same. We have different distances. We have defenders who are sometimes shooting over. And depending on my height and size, I might be comfortable in a different lift point than everybody else. So now I could connect my lift path to my lift point, which could be low, which is more around that chin area and lower. It could be below that. It could even be down to my shoulder. I could connect it to more of a medium lift point, which now that gives me a little clearance over defenders, but it still gives me a lot of strength out of my upper body. Or I could lift that ball into a higher lift point. That's more the traditional ones that every coach is always bugging you about, get that ball higher, but it's not always necessary.
We have to start being able to understand that those lift points exist and they're useful for different parts of the game of basketball. Shooting from close would require different lift points than shooting from far, which is a completely different topic. And then of course, after your lift point, you still have to have the release path. Now we're being very repetitive when we talk about these types of categories and these types of terms, but what you're doing is you're breaking the shot into just one small piece that you can start to see where a player is having problems. See, if a player gets to a lift point, but then their release path goes this way or that way, obviously that would be very easy things to correct, but you've identified the part of the shot that's a problem. See, the follow through isn't enough because you can follow through in different paths. And so we want to be able to have a consistent release path, but the actual path that you're traveling to actually get to the final release of the shot is something that we need to talk about, which is why a release path is part of every shot. And of course, we always end with the release point. Now, the release point is actually something that some people talk about, but they say things like this: hey, that player has a really high release. Now, when they say that, because no terminology has really been created, typically what people are trying to communicate is something in here. They'll call this a high release, but this is obviously a lift point. The release of the basketball hasn't occurred yet. So the real release point, if we're really gonna understand the term, is when the ball finally leaves our hand. And that can even have some variety based on the types of shots that you're taking, but in all actuality, we'll stay relatively consistent. But the whole purpose of all of these terms is to really start to understand what the anatomy of every shot is going to take and start to understand the areas that need to be improved. We start to simplify the act of shooting by simply creating the categories. It's not an overcomplicated process. You just simply have to learn a few words because those words help you label the categories and label, here's the big part, labels the details. See, if you can label the details, you can correct the details.
So if we can give better detail, if we can give better understanding, now as a trainer, now as a player, I can really make quicker changes to my shot and quicker adjustments even within a game. So understand those different stages, understand why we're really trying to emphasize to players why those stages are so important in their shot.
And so that is the anatomy of the shot, and that's why these terms need to be here for us to better understand the art of shooting. Oh, hey guys, didn't see you there. Welcome to the IPT YouTube channel. Make sure that you subscribe and turn on your post notifications so we don't have to bump into each other like this. Ha 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 ha!